Rachael as a child was hyper.
Very entertaining.
Yeah, very entertaining, but she was a nutter. She was mad.
A lovely nutter, though.
Mom, upside down.
Wind her up and off she goes.
It was like a wind-up toy, wasn't it?
When Shaun was a small child, he was just adorable, wasn't he? He was like a little mini tornado, always full of life, always tearing around.
Drove us nuts as well at times, but you know.
You knew when he was in the room, didn't you?
Yes, you did.
I think Shaun has always been born to be in front of a camera.
Oh.
I think Shaun loves the camera and the camera loves Shaun.
Yes, 100%.
I think that's definite.
I think growing up, it kind of felt like it was just a load of sisters.
Yeah.
Like, I've never felt like you guys are my cousins. That feels too distant.
Yeah.
Yeah, when you talk to other people, that they realise how close we are, they think it's a bit weird because not many other families are so close.
Rachael's role is teach us to dance.
Yeah, very much.
Teacher.
The leader.
The entertainer.
Yeah, the leader. There always had to be a show at the end of any family event.
Like, you don't really remember it coming about.
And I used to think everyone really enjoyed watching it, but I don't think they did.
Was always in sunglasses with a guitar performing in some way or another, trying to get everyone's attention. We used to go out to play, and nearly every time we'd go out, Shaun would end up crying because he'd done something, and I'd have to go home and tell Mum Shaun's had another accident. It was dramatic.
I met Shaun when we were 4-ish, and I don't remember anything until we were about 16. He used to run everywhere. So I'd ring him up and he'd be like, yeah, I'll be round in like 5 minutes. And he'd run round to my mum's house. Shaun used to film a lot. The first time I really remember a lot of filming going on was when we were probably 15.
About the time he started getting grounded a lot.
Yeah.
Because of the camera.
Ah, right.
Derek's camera, all the time. Just to think, he almost completely killed Shaun's career by not letting him.
And that's exactly why I prefer Marissa.
Well, there we are.
The first time I met Rach was at school. We didn't really like each other. My first impression was that she just was dancing all the time and it was just annoying. And then eventually we realised we both had really nice stationery and then we were friends. We used to do all our homework together, so we did tons of our history projects, making castles, and Rachael loved her camera and was always filming us doing really silly things. She always was great. She looked after me at school the whole time. She was brilliant. And I just did things to annoy her sometimes.
I met Shaun at the Cocked Hat. I always remember that from all the boys that worked in the Cocked Hat, Shaun was the only one that I didn't immediately think, oh yeah, he's a good lad.
Falaraki is an outstanding memory. The one thing that will stick in the mind is the 200 euro fishbowl. We going into it thinking, yeah, we're going to smash this. What was it, 7 bottles of vodka, 6 bottles of schnapps, or vice versa. And they had the music, was it from 300 playing?
Yeah, epic speech to start things off, and people then, coming over trying to get involved, and we're like, no,
we're going to do this. And then Shaun was found in a field. Is that right? He was carried to the sort of where they keep the luggage.
And woke up in the luggage storage.
I always remember Rachael being there. She's always been like a little safety cushion, like a little safety blanket. If you wrote us on paper, you wouldn't think we'd be friends because we are so polar opposites. She's so healthy and I'd happily eat McDonald's all day, every day. I can't dance, but I'm funny. Rachel's sense of direction, yeah, that's... How can you live in Caterham and still only know one way to get from your house to someone else's house? I mean, we're sitting in traffic, like, Rachel, you can go right here. Can I?
I first met Shaun Reynolds at university. Shaun and I bonded over playing guitar, so I think that's how we realised that each other existed, because we're both show-offs. I don't know what gives that impression, that I'm a show-off. I was adamant that he was a Japanese animation. Raise your hands at the wedding if you've seen Dragon Ball Z. Shaun really looks like a Japanese cartoon, that's what struck out. It's the eyes. Wasn't quite the lettuce I was looking for. I remember we were sat in my halls and we were playing music one night and then playing this song called Lettuce on My Doorstep, and then a fire alarm went off and everyone was getting out of bed, but we were all just had written this song. Everyone in the year on the campus went out to this fire point and we were singing our song, so it kind of became the anthem of the year. Lettuce on my doorstep, and I said no, 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 no. Lettuce on my doorstep, and I said go, 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 go. Went to buy a lettuce, but I ended up with a carrot. Wasn't quite the lettuce I was looking for.
So when me and Rachel went to university, we both got a house together. And yeah, we just clicked. It was weird because we hadn't been that close yet at college, and then suddenly we were like, just had loads in common. I remember the first night out and it was like neon and we were just like posing around Bognor, like on a bench with our leg up. And then there was another night in a shopping trolley. We just had such a laugh. Honestly, every day was a laugh. A memory that stands out to me at uni with Rach would be sat on the living room floor, putting the highlighting cap on her, pulling out all the hair and literally like slapping on the bleach. It was like bright blonde and dry. but it looked fine. But yeah, I remember doing that quite a lot actually.
So I first met Shaun in Colorado. He came to Colorado to do like some music stuff. And I remember I walked in and he was a lot taller than I expected. But it was like one of those things, you know, sometimes when you meet somebody and you just like instantly like are just friends with them. That was what we had for sure. Like, I don't even think we maybe said hi, but like it wasn't even like, hey, what's up, man? Like, it was like, what's up? And like just hugged each other. Yeah, that was the first time we met. Ooh, holla at me. I don't want no Shaun. A Shaun is a guy that can't get no
love. Like, I can remember the first time Rachel told me, I think, about Shaun was on the phone. I think she phoned and said to me, I've met someone. Up until then, Rachel had been quite independent, almost, I don't need anybody else. Probably we both knew at that point that it was someone special because she wasn't gonna just tell us about anybody.
Yeah, I had similar thoughts, but more, I hoped his parents were wealthy. just remembering what I was like at his age. So apart from that, I was dying to meet him, really.
We first heard of Rach when Shaun was at uni in Chichester. This beautiful little blonde, petite, lovely girl.
Blonde?
Yeah, she was blonde.
Was she?
She was blonde then. I know. Who knew? We went up to see Shaun.
No, no, no. We knew it was serious when we were invited up to see Shaun and we were going to be introduced to Rach.
I just remember the look on Rach's face, as in, please like him, and
how could we not like him?
He was, always go on first impressions. First impressions was, this is a good guy.
We couldn't have wished for a better partner.
You're absolutely right, yeah. Couldn't have wished for anyone better.
She laughs at all my jokes, which is great. Not many people do.
She put Shaun in his place, which is even better.
How would you describe your relationship with the new in-laws?
What do you think?
Do we have to answer this one? Can we move on to the next question, come back to it when we thought about it?
We tolerate them.
Yeah.
The first time I met Rach, I think, was at my mum's house at a barbecue I had around there. Shaun had brought around. Trev and I reenacted the picture. Rach had jumped on him and he'd starfished himself out as if to show no emotion towards her at all. And she'd gripped on him for dear life. Anyway, Trev and I reenacted that photo. That was the first time I met her, I think.
I don't remember. I don't remember first meeting him. He just rocked up one day.
I don't know. I don't remember Rach just not being there. She was just always part of the family.
My first impression of Shaun, oh, I wasn't kind. This lovely man came flopping over with his long hair and bright yellow shoes.
University would be the first time that I met Rach. Shaun introduced me to her. I think I might have been dressed as Banana Man as well.
Do you know what? I've always found Shaun really funny. I feel like we laugh at the same things and we are quite sick-minded. So I think when I first met Shaun, I just bounced off him because he was funny.
I first met Rachel at a nightclub called Sheik's, where my friend introduced me because she was with her friend Shaun. Hey Shaun.
I remember him hugging our nans. That's when he felt like one of the family.
He is sometimes annoying though.
I feel like I've known him for absolutely ages, when in reality I've probably...
Well, in reality, it's...
Well, I have.
10 years. Must be about 10 years.
I feel like I've known him for ages, but really I've only known him for 10 years.
Rach is very much part of the foundations now. One day we'll get a full-on argument out of her, and then that'll be the day she becomes completely one of us.
I like how Rach can hold her own. Like, the amount of banter that she gets thrown at her, she can chuck it back now. As soon as Rach started chatting back, you knew she was comfortable.
But I just remember meeting Shaun, and my first impression was he's wearing yellow shoes with very floppy hair, but he has a lovely smile.
And he was very nice to me, so I didn't mind. I mean, if he wasn't nice, you wouldn't be together now.
The first time I met Rachel was like probably a couple years after I met Shaun. I think now it's a pretty fun dynamic. Sorry, but sometimes we're kind of like picking on Rachel a little bit. But like in a fun, loving way. Also, sometimes Shaun does, like me and Rach gotta get on Shaun sometimes. So like sometimes me and Rach are teaming up on Shaun. Sometimes me and Shaun are teaming up on Rach. But they never really team up on me, I just realized. But it's always fun.
Right, Rachel is one of those people that's really annoyingly good at everything. So everyone's just like, no, obviously Rachel's lovely, talented, beautiful.
I've never taken her out on a date myself, or
never
smooched her in a drunken clinch. Or
my favourite memory of Rach is when she came to do my hair for my prom.
Rach also did my hair and makeup for prom. Oh. Did she put makeup on your legs, or was that just me?
I probably speak to Shaun and Rach probably every day in some way or another. We love to exchange some sort of Snapchat video with a filter about what we've been up to, any mishaps we might have had. We've got a WhatsApp called CR3 Massive, so we like to share on that, yeah.
Shaun and Rachel are the kind of people that will just drop what they're doing and fly out to New York for your wedding. Me and my wife, Gabrielle, we decided to get married in New York. None of this kind of fuss. I wouldn't have done it if Shaun wasn't there. I phoned him when I was looking at booking my flight, said, are you up for it? Immediately he said yes. We booked flights that night and we had a wild 5 days out in New York. I can't wait to stand up there at the altar with Shaun, just see that magical moment, much like he did for me.
Yeah.
Nowadays, me and Rach are more mature, but when we get together, we're still really giggly, we're really silly. We might not see each other as often as we like, but we always have that amazing connection. That is just our friendship, and that's what's so amazing about it.
The advice I give to the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Reynolds, oh, that's weird.
The first year, I remember thinking, oh, we can't go to bed angry, we've got to finish this argument. I mean, I just think just carry on being you, but just don't take each other for granted, because once you do that, then it's not going to work.
I would say if you're considering trying to win an argument with Rachel, Shaun, don't get your ambitions mixed up with your capabilities.
Here's some advice. How about you don't hoover at midnight? Rach. Rach, stop hoovering and blending Gone 11.
I'd say never say never.
I mean, you're already married, like,
yeah,
it's like you've been married forever already.
But maybe there'll be a bit more hugging.
How would you sum up the last 10 years? One word, go.
Adventure.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, think about what we've done. You're like the perfect sidekick. Because obviously I'm the main one.
Well, I'm Robin.
I wouldn't say we're Batman and Robin. I'd say we're more like Droopy and Dripple.
I don't know Droopy and Dripple.
I just showed you.
What about Pinky and the Brain? Which one would I be?
Pinky, obviously.
Which one's that? The one with the big ears?
No.
Oh.
I'm the Brain, obviously.
Yeah.
You're the silly one.
Our stag and hen weekends. They were just epic.
The stag do was the most incredible weekend, and I cannot explain what it meant to me to go away with those 25 odd lads and for them all to get on as well as they did.
Yeah.
And the stories that we've come back with are just priceless, aren't they?
Yeah, I think I can say exactly the same about the hen. I mean, I think I am known as the control freak amongst my friends. So to 100%. Have a whole weekend planned where I genuinely knew nothing, what they did was just beyond anything I could have ever done. It almost makes you realise why you love your friends so much, because they're just all such nice people.
I think we both believe that you are a product of the people that you surround yourself with, and that was kind of the whole intention behind making this video.
Yeah. I think this is meant to be a day all about us, but actually it's you guys that deserve some credit for helping us create the most amazing, happy memories over the last 10 years. And we count ourselves lucky every day that we know each and every one of you.